हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम गायत्री बुडालकर एंड माय टीममेट्स श्रेया जावने एंड हिमांशु मोरे प्रेजेंटिंग हियर अ ट्रैफिक लाइट कंट्रोलर यूजिंग VHDL. सो इन दिस वीडियो विल बी डिस्कसिंग स्टेप बाय स्टेप गाइड फॉर इम्प्लीमेंटिंग ट्रैफिक सिग्नल कंट्रोलर यूजिंग ज़ाइलिन सॉफ्टवेयर, देयर एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस, एंड एट लास्ट विल सी पेपर पब्लिशिंग प्रोसेस एंड प्लैगरिज्म चेक. लाइक एज वी ऑल नो, मॉनिटरिंग ट्रैफिक सिग्नल is the most crucial thing that any country can do to safeguard its citizen from heavy traffics as well as from accidents. So to overcome this, a combination of multiple algorithms are already being used, and using FPGA, field programmable gate array, and Verilog hardware description language VHDL, it is one of them. And our aim is to design an error free traffic control system which will be effectively used for street intersection. Now let's discuss the scenario of the road first. Here we can see a conventional four road arrangement with north, east, west and south direction, each having three traffic lights, red, yellow, green. And this will work in such a way that initially all red signals will be turned on. Then after a few seconds, the green signal light in one direction turns on, that will allow traffic to travel in straight, right and left direction. And remaining yellow signal, it is divided into two, Y1 and Y2. When Y1 will be on in on condition, the pedestrian signal will be off. And when Y2 will be in on condition, the pedestrian signal will be on. That will allow people to cross the road. And the northbound traffic will be permitted to go first, and it will be followed by east, south and west direction respectively. Generally, to design any real traffic light signal system, linear and electromagnetic sensors are used, where a linear sensor, it is used to detect the presence of the vehicles, and other will determine the volume of traffic corresponding to that lane. So here was the overall depiction of what actually it will work. Now let's see the simulation part. Shreya, you are on mute.
So here are the steps to simulate any logic using Xilinx software. The very first step of this process is to create new project. So here in the file option, you will see this option, new project. Just click on this option. It will launch a new project window. Then give the project name and specify the directory path where you wish to store this project. Then the next step will be creating a VHDL source. So click on this file name. Then you will get the option to create a new source. Click on that. Then this window will come up. Here you have to select the VHDL module and give a file name. Then choose the location where you have to want to store this source file. Then click on the next. After that, this window will come up. Here you have to assign the VHDL source ports. You can name the ports here in this section, like clock or reset, whatever your inputs and outputs. Like in this case, clock and reset will be input, and the three LEDs like red, green and yellow will be the output. So from this drop-down boxes, you have to select in for input, and for out, you have to select the out. Then click on the next. So this window will come up. Here you have to dump your code. Whatever the logic you have built, you have to write that in this window. After that, you have to synthesize your code. So here in the left corner, here is the option synthesize XST. After clicking on this, it will synthesize your code or it will check your syntax. So after completion of this IIC compilation, a green check mark shows. If the IIC process was successful, then it will show green. Otherwise, a red cross will come up, which indicates that the process failed due to some problem. So after that, here is the RTS schematic. RTL schematic view is nothing but a registered transfer level graphical representation of your design. It is generated by the synthesized tool at the earlier stage of a synthesized process. It shows a representation of the pre-optimized design in terms of the generic symbols like this AND gates, etc. After that, this is the behavioral model simulation. For that, you have to click on the simulate behavioral model to test the behavior model. We can choose other modeling methods also, like data flow or structure modeling. But any hardware description can be accurately simulated using these behavioral waveforms. So we can really see whether our output is correct or not. Here in this case, this sensor and the clock is our input. So, and this red light, green light, and yellow light are our outputs. So for some seconds, red light will turn on. Turning off this red light, green light will turn on, and after some time the yellow light will turn on as soon as green light turns off. So this was the working of this model. Next, Himanshu will explain the further part.
So I'll explain the advantages of VHDL over the other languages. So VHDL supports a variety of design processes, including the top-down and bottom-down approaches. It also is a versatile design language. It enables for a more effective design management. VHDL also enables precise implementations and also allows for several levels of the abstraction and ensures that the lower levels of the designs are tightly coupled. VHDL is compatible with every CAD software and is actively encourages the reuse and exchange of the code. And now some of the disadvantages of the VHDL. Next slide. So the disadvantages are visualizing and troubleshooting a design is a more complex method of this simulation. Some VHDL programs are unable to synthesize for some reasons, and learning VHDL is a more challenging than the other languages. So next slide. This is the our paper submission. Next. This is the plagiarism which is checked by ourselves. Next. And here is the conclusion. The latest methods of the multi-way traffic management vastly enhance the traffic situations. Traffic light management systems assist in maintaining an orderly flow of cars. Traffic light controller will be used to learn the basic stages involved in the designing and simulating any circuit using Xilinx software. Next. Thank you.